And everyone worked very hard, so I appreciate you showing your appreciation.
Okay, so with the good help of the people from Polycom, we have a very special guest who hopefully will come up on this screen. So let's... Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Larry Kramer. So, Larry, we have a question for you. Can you see us? We can see you on the screen. Can you see the people in this auditorium?
Yes, I can. Thank you for coming.
Good. Well, on behalf of Sundance Institute, thank you very much for doing this for us today. Gene's asked me to ask you the first question myself, so I'm really curious as to why you agreed to do the documentary.
She twisted my arm. No. I don't know. I didn't want to do it. I look upon it as some sort of end-of-life gesture that I would rather put off for a few years. But having seen the documentary and it says so much of the many things that I have said, it's another way to get my message across. So, it all, in the end, turned out to be a very moving experience. I gotta tell you, it's really hard looking at yourself in the hospital, almost dead, and Theodore trying his best to get you through your wedding. And shaming you and just keeping me alive. It's, people should see that. The world should see what we go through.
Well, we're very happy you're here,
of course,
to say the least. All right, so we're going to open this up for Q&A. If you have any questions for Gene or Larry, raise your hand. I'll call on you. Please try to speak as loudly as possible. I'm going to repeat the question regardless for anyone. So, gentlemen right down front here. Yes.
Larry, what's the next level of activism needed for the LGBTQ community?
Did you hear that, Larry? The question was, what is the next level of activism that the LGBT community needs?
It needs to show its face. One question I have never been able to answer or live with is why so few gay men and women are out there fighting for our lives, for any of our issues. ACT UP at its most didn't have, if we had 10,000 people across the country, we'd have a lot. There were how many, 20 million of us? Why aren't we fighting for our equality? We don't have it. And I'm not talking about gay marriage, I'm talking about everything. I'm talking about what's done to adoption, for having decent health care. Everything that straight people have, we should have, and we don't. And most of all, of course, we don't have any cure for this plague. It's 35 years. AIDS is 35 years old. AIDS has been with us 35 years. We should know more. They should know more about what is happening that hasn't happened. Why has been there so little progress in developing a cure? Why have presidents refused to pay attention to it? why has the NIH and every other government agency paid attention to it sufficient to make something happen? 35 years, more people will die from AIDS than will ever die from Ebola.
Okay, anyone else? Sure, this gentleman right here. And who's your question for?
It's for Larry, but first I want to thank Gene and Sundance for bringing us this film. Larry, it's Jim Fouratt. I wanted to ask you a question about what is the current treatment protocol, the giving of Truvada to healthy bodies.
Okay.
What do you think about it?
Larry, did you hear that? The gentleman's question was the current protocol of giving Truvada to healthy bodies. What do you think of that?
I think it's a very mixed blessing. It's a very mixed event. I wouldn't even call it a blessing. All of these anti-AIDS medicines, which are saving our lives and keeping us alive a little longer, are all overflowing with side effects. And there's no reason that Truvada won't turn out to have the side effects that AZT had years ago. The knee you saw in the hospital was partly caused by drugs to weren't doing what they were supposed to be doing. They're 35 years and we should know more. I say that over again. You should know that there's a problem with all these. These are chemotherapies. And that is not like eating a lollipop. Do I think everyone should take Truvada? If they're going to have sex, and yes, it's useful if you prick yourself by accident or something. What I'm terribly afraid of, and I see happening, is it's just another reason for gay people to go out and do again what got us into trouble in the first place. Take the pill, you won't get infected. And that's going to happen more and more. Doesn't mean we shouldn't have the drug. It should mean that we're better educated. It should mean that gay people, as a community, as a population, we're not a community anymore, we're a population, should have more of a sense of responsibility for our future, for the future, for our present, all of us.
No, I have a question for Gene. How was Larry Kramer as a subject to work with for your documentary?
Well, his reputation, I guess, did inspire some fear. But the closer I got to Larry as I was shooting this, and I was at times, you know, I've known Larry a long time, but you know, I wasn't a dear friend. So I was in the hospital room with him when he was in a very needy place, and I saw him at times, you know, very suffering, just suffering. And I have to say, I just saw a very sweet side of him, and I understand his shyness, and he's ultimately a shy man. And he's, you know, so the experience of making it, I think, other than the fear that we were going to lose him, it was an excellent experience. And also not just meeting Larry, but getting to meet David Webster, who is Larry's partner. It was very moving to be part of the team that was...
Your husband, my husband.
That's right, your husband, Larry. That's right.
Anyone else? There's the guy all the way in the back. Yes, you.
Yeah. So I have a question. This can be answered, I guess, in part by both. The relationship between Larry and Anthony Fauci, from the FDA. Is that something that continues to this day? And was there an effort to reach out to other people from the government and get commentary on this story?
Okay, I'm sure Gene heard that, but Larry, the question for the gentleman, it was a question for both you and Gene. He's inquiring about your relationship with Larry Fauci, which we witnessed in the film. Does that relationship continue today? And was there a second part?
And was there an effort to reach out to other people in the government to get their comments?
And was there an effort to reach out to other people in the government to get their comments?
Well, I'll just say in terms of other people in the government, not really, because there was a certain point which we had a lot of interviews, and the interviews with Larry and with Fauci, I thought were the primary story, because their relationship is so complex and because it did really change history. But Larry has a long-term history with Tony, and where are you at it now, Larry? With Tony, how do you feel about him overall?
My relationship with Dr. Fauci is probably the most complicated one I have ever had. This is a man who both helped to, I use the word murder us, and he's also a man who has helped to save my life, and it's hard to write about him, as I am doing in my novel, The American People, without taking a strong stand with whatever issue. I do think that the National Institute of Infectious Diseases, which Tony runs, is shockingly inept, and that he has been. It's just taken 35 years for them to do anything, and he's in charge. He's in charge. This is the man in the garden who's in charge of our lives. Who knows what goes through the man's head when you put that at night? I don't.
Okay, so very calm. So we have time for two more questions. And the first is this lady right here. Yes.
Yes, coming off of the great success of The Normal Heart on HBO, I'm curious about how HBO got involved and where you were in this process with the film and HBO's involvement.
The question was, coming off the great success of The Normal Heart on HBO, her question was for Gene, how did HBO get involved in this process and what is their hope for it?
I had been making this film for about 3 years, and when The Normal Heart came into HBO, it opened up the door for the documentary to come into HBO, and I was very pleased about that, because Sheila Nevins put the most amazing team behind this, and I, you know, the piece, it couldn't have been, you know, what it is today without the kind of resources that HBO brought to it. Just the rights alone, you know, we have scenes from, some major motion pictures. It really brought the resources we needed to do Larry justice.
And I want to chime in here, too, because I just want to thank HBO, because they bring us so much. Can you hear us?
Say something?
Yes.
Okay.
Can I say something?
Well, anyway, on behalf of Sundance, well, HBO has brought us so
much.
All right, Tommy.
I want to talk. One more minute.
Hello?
Did you lose it? Do you still have the audio? Larry, can you hear me right now?
Yes. HBO has been the most wonderful company I've ever worked with. Not only with the movie of The Normal Heart, which they were just so generous and kind, supportive, but with Gene's documentary through Sheila Nevins, also at HBO. They don't come any better than Sheila and Mike Lombardo and Dick and Len. I've never worked with people like that before. I come out of the old movie business, the days of the 70s, and where everybody was knifing everybody in the back. So I'm very grateful to them. And more people saw the movie of the normal heart than would ever see in from a Hollywood movie or from or even from the play.
Okay, and we have time for one more question. So, sure, this gentleman right here.
I was just wondering if you ever imagined that cable access footage of you talking about faggots with Vito Russo would ever be like in a documentary projected in a theater in the future, and if you had a sense that at that point in your life, like, you were making history.
Larry, the question was for you. The gentleman he's talking about the cable access footage of you and Vito Russo when you were talking about faggots. If it ever occurred to you that that footage would ever be used in a documentary, and if it ever occurred to you that you were making history at the time.
I don't think that way in terms of making history. I have to tell you that I don't think I'm doing anything so particular that anybody else couldn't do. I have an opinion, I feel strongly about it, and I express it. Every single one of us, everyone who's in this audience, is capable of doing just the same. I don't think everybody thinks about whether they're making history or not as they can complain or film or whatever. You do your job. And this is my job.
Well, thank you very much for doing your job, Mr. Kramer, because you say your job has saved so many people's lives, and your art has enriched so many of our lives. And thank you so much to Gene Carlomusto for chronicling your history, and to all of you for coming out and joining us and spread the good word about Larry Kramer with Love and Anger and Thanks God. Bye, Larry. We'll all see you guys.
Well done, Larry.